Hello everyone, it's me, D-Tap, again, and we're back here in Hogwarts Legacy. So, we just ended up getting level 15, so I should be able to go to talents. And I want to pick up. Oh, not that, it's core. What's in rumor requirements? Invisibility potions, undetected effects, last longer. Very, not really worried about that right now. I want to grab this core basic cast mastery to reduce cooldowns on our abilities. Let's pick that up. All right, we'll go back. I want to head to our room of requirements real quick. Is there something I wanted to do, if I can remember? We'll pick up our plants for one. Because, oh, that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to identify our gear. So, let's see. We have glasses 32, 37. We'll clip those. And is the other one a scarf? Yes, so 31 or 33. We'll go with a 33. I think that's it for that stuff for now. And let's take a look at our quest. All right, so we got Beast classed. Pressure Sharps assignment still. Pop Balloons. Sendo appearances. You know what? Let's just go to the Beast class. We'll do our main story class things this episode. Where is that? All right, so oop. Bell Tower, Beast Classroom. We'll go ahead and do this class and see what's up with the beast. But I do need to start doing a whole bunch of the side quests and stuff to unlock all the stuff we need. Let's begin.
Welcome, everyone. I see you've already met some of the many beasts we study in this class. Though be advised, none of these creatures should be taken lightly. They are all, in their own way, dangerous. Especially if one does not know how to handle them properly. Now, it seems many of you are out of practice. Let's take some time to review the basics of how to care for a beast, shall we? Miss Sweeting, would you please assist our new student with the lesson today?
Yes, Professor Howin. Hello, I'm Poppy Sweeting. Don't worry about Professor Howin's speech. She overexaggerates sometimes. All the beasts in class are perfectly safe. Oh!
Miss Sweeting, pay attention, please. The tongue of a Puffskeen can be a slippery devil.
Yes, Professor.
Yes.
Here, you can practice on Gerald. Just keep an eye out for his tongue.
All
You can
right.
use my brush. Just be gentle. Oh, and think pleasant thoughts. I like to think it enriches his experience.
All right, so we need to brush them. Oh, I gotta actually assign this to. Well, let's put it there, I guess. Hey.
That's lovely. I'm sure he feels much better. I think he might be hungry. Would you mind giving him some beast feed?
All right. Then I need to. Oop. Find the feeding.
What do you suppose the pellets taste like to Gerald? Pudding, I like to think. I think we can safely say that Gerald likes you.
That's good news. He seems very nice.
He is. Kindness is one of his best qualities, right after ambition and cleanliness.
Good work, everyone. Now, let's make our way to the pens and select another beast. And please, do be careful as you feed and groom them. Miss Sweeting, why don't you show our new student to the Neasels in the farthest pen?
Neasel?
The Neasels are over here.
They're big cat-looking things.
Couple of Neasel whiskers ought to get me a few canuts at least. Enough to buy something from Honeyjukes. Stupid thing.
What in Merlin's name are you doing?
Tuss tuss, peculiar Poppy. Worried about a worthless little rodent.
Her name is Persephone!
Her name is Persephone.
That's really not funny.
Slytherins.
Let's go.
Those two don't belong anywhere near this class. Poachers in training. Persephone was onto them instantly. Thank you for your help. Let's carry on. Feed and brush the Neasels just as you did with Gerald.
Let's feed them.
The Neasels really took to you. They know a good egg when they see one. As do I.
It appears our time has come to an end. Please close the pens and see yourselves out.
I didn't even go in the pen.
Where is our new student? Ah, there you are. I would like a moment, please.
Okay.
Hello, Professor. You wanted to speak with me?
I did. How did you find your first beast lesson?
I enjoyed it.
It was wonderful. I believe I'm really going to enjoy this class.
Good. You seem to understand that when beasts are properly controlled, they can play a vital role in our lives. Some provide us with magically imbued materials, if cared for correctly, which does not include torturing them for whiskers. Well done, by the way. Probably best to let me handle it next time.
Yes, Professor.
They're nearly as bad as the savagers in Rookwood's poacher pack. Sadly, we're the ones who suffer, stumbling over dead beasts. Terrible waste of resources.
Surely the poachers can be brought to justice by someone. The Ministry, perhaps?
An optimistic idea. Now, why don't we focus on more immediate matters that we can control? Professor Weasley has asked that I prepare some assignments designed to help you catch up to the other fifth years. Be on the lookout for my owl. Meanwhile, I also encourage you to study as many beasts as you can on your own time.
I need to talk to you. Come here.
Oh, jeez. All right, what's up?
Do you need something, Poppy?
Thank you again for saying something to those brutes so that I didn't have to. You were an augury at noon in the desert.
I certainly hope that's a good thing.
It's something my gran and I say. It means that something or someone is a welcome surprise. At least, that's what we decided it meant.
I couldn't stand there and watch them harm the poor thing.
We're of a similar mind. Actually, in light of that, there's someone I'd like you to meet in the forest.
Oh, sounds intriguing.
Me. Very well, lead the way.
I'd hoped I would.
What kind of beast you got hiding back there?
I wouldn't take just anyone there. In fact, you're the first.
Really? Well, thank you, I think.
As I said, we think alike. Pleasant surprise. Quite the weather we're having, don't you think?
Poppy, where are you taking
moonstones?
It really is much better if I just show you. Don't worry, we're nearly there. It's just ahead.
All right.
Stand back. Please meet Highwing. Isn't she just magnificent?
Go on, bow.
Introduce yourself to her. But be careful. You must always show hippogriffs the proper courtesy before you approach them.
Why didn't you bow? A bow some more. There's the acknowledgement. Now I can pet it.
I knew it. I don't think I've ever seen a hippogriff take to someone this quickly. You can feed and brush her if you'd like. I come and check on her every once in a while. Bring her pasties, tell her what's going on in the castle. You wouldn't know from looking at her, but she's a dreadful busybody.
Those don't look like ferrets. The heck?
So, what did you think of Highwing?
She was brilliant.
I thought she was brilliant. Can't believe you introduced me to her.
I suspected you two might get along.
Are you the reason students have been seeing hippogriffs flying above the Forbidden Forest?
Perhaps. Did you know that once you earn a hippogriff's trust, they'll always be there for you? I've seen it firsthand with her.
How exactly did you and Highwing cross paths?
It's a longer story. But I rescued her from poachers a few years back, got her to safety, and well, she was fine until recently. You may have noticed that poachers are something of a problem in the area, so I worry they could get her again, and I might not be there next time.
Professor Howard mentioned the poachers as well. She seemed to imply that we couldn't rely on the Ministry to help.
I don't often agree with Professor Howard, but on that, I fear she's right. The poachers' influence is growing. I see them every day in the village, lingering, talking to people. They're up to something. I'm just not sure what.
I'm suspicious.
Strange. Sounds as if they're planning something.
Exactly. I think I'm going to look into it. Find out what's going on, what they're doing.
You know, this is a hard choice. Because you could get in trouble or in danger.
But I think that's a fine idea. Information is power.
And the more I know, the better I can keep hiring safe.
You seem undeterred. Will you let me know what you find out?
Oh, very well. I will. I should be going, but we'll speak again soon, I hope.
Oh, money. All right, what else can we do today? Quest. The caretakers. Lunar. Ooh. That will, let me unlock stuff. Now, how does one? We need a Hogwarts map. The Great Hall? Or Grand Staircase? Grand Staircase. We'll fast travel there. And then we should be able to get the unlock spell. So we can actually go around unlocking stuff.
Imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented flu powder.
Alright, he's above us. I'm guessing it's a he. Ooh.
Again, Mr. Moon.
Oh, I was hoping to see you again, my young friend. Gladwin Moon, a Hogwarts caretaker, at your service. First, please allow me to apologize if I seemed a bit unsteady when we last met. I'm afraid I had a rather disconcerting encounter. Although I hear your visit to Hogsmeade was even more eventful than mine.
I suppose you could call it eventful. I certainly wasn't expecting a troll attack.
Oh, of course not. From what I understand, the village was lucky you were there. In fact, my recent visit to Hogsmeade is the reason I was hoping to bump into you. I could use your help with something. Do you see that curious statue over there? Watch what happens when that light changes from day to night. Humoring me for a moment. See if you can remove the moon from the statue.
Go on, play the moon.
Oh, odd little contraptions, aren't they? It seems the statue vanishes once the moon is removed. Which, incidentally, can only be done at night. Why don't you hold on to that one for now, and I'll explain more as we walk. Ever since that fateful day in the village, those curious statues have begun appearing about the castle. A fair number have been strewn around Hogsmeade. Someone, it seems, is trying to torment me. You see, that day in Hogsmeade, I turned a corner and came face to face with a boggart, or shapeshifter, if you will, which takes the form of whatever scares you most. This one took the form of a demiguise.
A demiguise?
Yes, terrifying creature that can see the future. Wholly unnerving. I encountered one when I was a lad in Korea. Terrible experience. Those statues are demiguises. The moons, I assume, are an uninspired play on my name. Some jackanapes used a boggart to learn my greatest fear and use it against me. I have my suspicion as to the scoundrel or scoundrels responsible. It is my hope that they will slip up and reveal themselves as the statues disappear. That is why I need your help in removing the statues.
Why me?
A couple of reasons, frankly. First, your daring do against those trolls in Hogsmeade has gained you a reputation for fearlessness. Second, as macabre and hideous as a demiguise is, most would find my fear of them unwarranted. You, however, have seen how they affect me. I'm at my wit's end, young friend. I simply can't bring myself to go near them. In fact, I know of two statues right here in the faculty tower. Perhaps you could start simply by removing them, so I can go about my evening duties.
Yeah. I'd be happy to help.
I'd be glad to help you, Mr. Moon.
Oh, I knew I could count on you. First, you know how to cast a disillusionment charm, correct? You'll want to do that before wandering the tower at night. Next, you'll notice that the door is locked. However will you get in? Alohomora, that's how.
But what about curfew?
Curfew? Oh, tosh. I sense you're a bit like me when I was your age. Oh, the school was my oyster. And I took advantage of it. Oh, everyone loved me for it. Oh, those were the days. Now, you'll find one statue in the prefect's bathroom and the other in the hospital wing. Good luck. Oh, and thank you.
All right, so... A-A-X-Y-B... Hey. All right, let's go ahead and we'll switch these. And I already have the disillusionment. Yep. So then I can do... Did he give me the... Unlock yet?
Alohomora.
Oh wow. All right, so this is spinning. There we go.
Well done. You're in. Remember, use a disillusionment charm so no one claps eyes on you. This is a restricted area of the castle, after all.
All right. Wordy figures. All right. That actually helps out. What is this? We'll pick that up. Retrieve the demiguise. Level 2 lock. Sweets. Chest.
Rather poorly, I'd say.
Is that so?
Level 3 lock.
Raising a generation of coddled cape flappers that can scarcely.
Let's do this real quick.
This must be the prefect's bathroom.
Alohomora. Yep, somewhere over here. There we go. Like that. Prefect's bathroom. All right, we'll get back out of here. Gotta get him to move.
Students in the hospital wing on account of my venomous tentacular.
Not at the moment, no. Plenty of other perils and pitfalls to send them my way, though. Well, I suppose I should begin my rounds now.
I suppose Professor Black knows best, but the students are terribly disappointed about Quidditch being canceled.
Huh. I had planned to bet a few galleons on Hufflepuff.
Hufflepuff? Alright, so we need to go downstairs now?
Ravenclaw would not have been that. Not this year, anyway.
I'm partial to Hufflepuff myself.
Can I look at my, year? Worth 90. Let's just destroy one of these so I can see what's in that chest.
It's a majestic sport. Encompasses the whole of the human condition.
Let's go back downstairs. And we get our spell. And I need to go sell all this stuff. I probably should look for some more, let's do our thing here. Here we go. Oh, wait. I thought I seen that uploading page. Yep. Uh-oh. Oh, no. I'll try again. I had to try to get that page. I didn't even see him there. All right, did we grab? Yeah. Sneaky, sneaky, sneaky. I'm just gonna get out of here. We can always get the stuff later on. Come on. You saw nothing. Alright.
Hello, Mr. Moon. I have the moons you asked me to collect.
Oh, goodness! You're as fearless as I'd hoped. An excellent start. If we can collect more, it may shed some light on who's behind all this. Of course, I first suspected Peeves. He drove the previous caretaker, Rancorous Carp, to an early retirement with his intolerable buffoonery. But that does not explain the boggart in Hogsmeade, does it? No. I am determined, with your help, to discover the identity of my tormentor.
Be glad to help.
It's definitely intriguing. I'd like to help you solve this mystery.
You, my friend, are a gentle person and a scholar. And I have something to offer in exchange for your assistance. Now, remember, the moons are only retrievable at night. Thus, I encourage you to use a disillusionment when necessary.
Keep a look.
Understood. I shall keep an eye out.
I appreciate that.
All right.
Oh, and I knew you were the one to ask for help. Keep at it so we can solve this mystery.
We can get a gauge here. I need to go sell. Travel to Hogsmeade. We'll sell real quick.
Does it get any more cozy than Hogsmeade?
We have everything a young student might need when it comes to potions. Have a good look at it.
Alright, let's look at our gear, make sure we got everything. Alright, it looks like we got everything. That's the best for us, already equipped. Oh.
What can I do for you today?
Go to sell. We'll start selling all this stuff. Get rid of all of it. Now we have some money to play around with. We could get some stuff for potion making. Still trying to decide on what I want to spend my money on. Oh, let's talk to him though. Oh yeah, I delivered the packages for this guy.
I delivered the potions to Fatima Luang.
Very good. And did she cause you any trouble?
There's no problem.
Nothing to worry about. I handled it.
Glad to hear it. And thank you again for your help.
Thank you.
It was a pleasure doing business with you, Mr. Pippin.
Likewise. Worth every bit of that delivery fee to have someone capable deal with that witch.
Best of luck with your potions, Mr. Pippin.
Do take care.
All right, let's look at, can we just get a, oh no, parents or something. All right, well, let's look at our collections. This is just the way stuff looks. Cosmetic alterations applied to gear via the change appearance option in the gear menu. Peaked Skull Mask, Dark Arts. Let's actually look to see if we can actually do any of that. Oh, we can. Well, let's make the beaked mask ours, I guess. Oh, actually, we can use like any of the ones that we already have. I think I just want to go with like a square glasses. Can we change the appearance of this? Yes. All right, we actually already have the flat cap. Probably just roll with that for now. Change appearance. We can make it so it doesn't show up. That's actually cool. X. I think I want to roll with the Hufflepuff. Dragonhide Protector's Cloak. Outfit. Legendary Armored. Let's just go with a midnight one here. Maybe? Doesn't really change anything. Alright. Gloves? We can change the way those look. What are we wearing? Quidditch gloves. Those actually look cool. Alright. So we'll roll with that. Go to quest. What's this? Side quest? Man behind the moons. So I need to return 9 of those moons. And it unlocks Alohomora 2 and 3. Purchase a broom enhancement from Albie Weeks. Oh, let's go to Albie Weeks and see what he got. Hey.
Welcome back. I've arranged a special price on the broom upgrade for you. Ravelli, we appreciate all of your help.
Alright, well, let's talk. Mr. Weeks. Well, I'm gonna get this broom enhancement.
You'll be thrilled with that broom, I promise you.
Alright. That cost me 1,000.
I must tell you, half of Hogsmeade's been by the shop asking about rumors of a broom upgrade. Without the information you provided, my work would have taken twice as long. Thank you again. It may sound ambitious, but I've already begun work on another upgrade, more difficult to perfect than the last. I wondered, would you be interested in joining forces again? There's another course near Irondale that Miss Reyes has mastered. If you were to test this first upgrade there, it may help me as I develop the next. Oh, you'll consider it, won't you?
Sure.
Sounds as if you're really outdoing yourself. If I'm able to help, I will.
Thank you. I know this recent success was only the beginning of what I can do for Broom Flight. Report back as soon as you can, and we'll be off to the races.
Yeah. Alright, so I need to go to gear. Alright, it's already equipped. I didn't know if I was going to have to actually equip it myself or if it would automatically do it. But apparently, it automatically does it.
Off to the races, then.
Alright, what is this? Money? Dig it? How do I get up there? Don't mind me. I just seen a bag of money or something up here. Nothing else? Oh no, there's something still up top.
Hello, Homura.
There we go.
Mine now, Demi guys.
Oh, cool. There's another one of those guys. Suit of armor. Blazer. I think that's... Oh, no, wait. There's... this. Take that. Alright, let's head out of here now. Well, there's actually a person here we can talk to for a side quest. Oh, I don't want to go out the back door. How did I miss the staircase to go down? Oh, because I didn't go all the way down. Explains a lot. Alright, we can't talk to her yet, but we can talk to this person.
Pardon me, but were you saying something?
Oh, hello. Talking to myself. I'm Clementine Willardsey, charmed. I was musing on the precious butterflies I see near the edge of the forest. Whenever I come near, they fly off into it. When I was at Hogwarts, we truly were forbidden from entering the forest. Told horrible stories about it, and I've had an irrationally intense fear of it ever since. It's silly, but I'm insatiably curious as to where the butterflies go in the forest. You couldn't possibly find out, could you?
You want me to follow the butterflies?
I do, yes, if you wouldn't mind.
Look into it.
Very well. If I have time, I shall see where they lead.
Much more courage than I ever did. You can usually find me right around here. I hope to see you soon.
All of the butterflies.
Don't forget, the butterflies always seem to be on the fringes of the Forbidden Forest. Good luck.
Yep.
Rebellion.
Alright, so where do we want to go?
Sometimes it seems all roads lead to Hogsmeade.
Hello, Homura.
Where? There's spinning. So basically, with the locks, you just got to find out where you need to position the rings, and they'll start spinning once you got them in the right location. And then, you just gotta hold both of them in the correct position. Doo-doo-doo. Until it unlocks. We'll collect that. Search the chest. Just breaking into people's houses. Don't mind me. Oh, that's a level 3 lock. We won't be getting in there. What about this back here? Yeah, this is one of those eyeball chests. Yep. The disillusionment actually works on those. I had a feeling it might. Alright, let's... Oh, wrong spell. Alright, we have some weird blue stuff over here. I think that's a level 3 lock. Door. Actually, this door is not even locked. Why is... Alright, do we got any blue spells? Let's switch spell sets and... We'll try repair. Oh. Alright, I don't know how to get in there yet either. Oop, there's a chest.
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented blue.
Hogsmeade, here I come.
I already looked at that lock, right? At level 3. Oh, I gotta find a butterfly. I need Lumos. Alright. I gotta figure out where that's at. Can we get in here? Yep. Oop, there is a... This is... Probably don't need to be invisible for all this stuff. Oh. I've seen the... Butterfly... Well, let's go back to that picture frame. There we go. Look at that. Oop. Level 3 lock. Can't do anything with that yet. Alright, let's make ourselves invisible. There's a chest outside, apparently. Oh, I didn't want the cupcake. Or not cupcake. Muffin. Oh, no, that was cupcake. Alright, so we need to go in this one. Oh, that's the same place. We need to go behind this building. All right.
Does it get any more cozy than Hogsmeade?
Another big old chest. Level 2 lock. Just going through collecting everything in Hogsmeade, I guess. Still gotta figure out that door. That's a level 3 lock.
What are you up to now?
Nunya. Alright, Ollivanders. Level 2 lock.
Rebellion. Alohomora.
I like how you can just open stuff up right next to people. And they don't care. Step 1, not breaking and entering. Alright, let's go into this building, because I think there's something in here as well. Chest. Alright, I don't see anything over there. See a bunch of stuff in here.
Take your time looking about. Plenty of wonderful books to stoke a curious mind like yours.
Well, your chests over here are,
What do we have here? A demigod.
What's getting me interested. Alright, so we come back after being out of sight of it, and then we can open it. And we get a bunch of money. Alright, so we need to also do something like, this would be map. Oh, let's try, change the time of day so we can pick this statue up. Where am I? Why am I stuck? Look at them, guys.
Revelio.
All right, so there's a chest over here. Grab that page. I get everything from Hogsmeade, I guess. There's a lot of stuff here, though. Alright. Stuff in here. But I want to get in that chest. Oh, there's another Demi, guys.
Rebellion.
If there's a chest outside. Not mistake. Yeah, there's another chest out here. All right. Let's go down here. I need to change my spells to, so I can do my invisibility. And then we can come open this one up. More money. Alright. The collection chest. The Hogsmeade's actually pretty big. Continue looking around. He's in our rebellion. Oh, level 2 lock, so I can't do anything about that one. Level 3. Is there anything in this building? Yep. And there we go. Alright, where's the little chest or bag? And that's everything in here. Alright, what else? Loading page back here. Let's change our spells back. Get out of sight of that chest, then we can come back. Alright, what level is this? Level 3. Alright, nothing around here right now. I guess Zonko's joke shop doesn't have anything in it. Makes sense. Okay, there is a bag of some kind over here. Money. All right, what's in there? Bag of stuff. There's stuff upstairs. Okay, I need to sell some stuff. Are you a vendor? No. All right. Where's my nearest vendor person? You should work. Take that field guy page. Alright, let's sell to this guy. Plenty to choose from here, so take your time. Actually, before we do anything, expect you have a sharp eye for fashion. Stop by whenever you're about. Let's go to gear, see what's the best. 31, 32, don't know. Alright. 37. Don't know. Alright, we can sell that scarf. What are we wearing? We're wearing a 25. I'm kind of just going to go with a 34. Let's load up the 28. Alright, let's talk to him. And we'll sell all the stuff that we're not wearing. Or we'll keep the stuff that's not identified for now. And we'll sell all this other stuff. $4,000? Ooh, demiguys. I also see a chest there, so. See that. We'll come back, grab this chest. The bag behind him. We have tons of money now. But we still have a bunch of stuff to do here. And Hogsmeade, apparently. Let's grab this page real quick. But I think I'll call it here for this video. We'll continue searching Hogsmeade and stuff and collecting stuff. But I think I'm gonna call it here. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed, and I hope to see you in the next one.